What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to Get and Go. Stands for Get in the Truck and Get Outdoors. Today, I'm getting in the truck and I'm headed back to my buddy Matt's for round two of turkey season. First weekend wasn't so great. The weather put a damper on our plans. I didn't get as much footage as I'd like to get. I had no footage of us truck camping. So today, I'm headed out to his place. I'll be camping there in my truck for the weekend. I do plan on doing a great camp and cook one of my most favorite meals when I camp. Stay tuned and don't miss out on that.
Pickup line all set up. Pretty decent view. Catch them coming over the hill. Catch them walking the field.
I think we're all right.
Hey, how's it going?
Good place for the blind.
What's that?
Good place for the blind.
That's a good place. You're gonna get one this year.
You're gonna haul. Should have been doing this the whole time.
I've got the truck and your blind in the picture.
So, he's setting up the cameras now. Go for a walk up here.
Here in this corner is where we camped out last year in the spring. Kind of down in the hill. That's where we see us. Just park the trucks there. Probably might camp there again this year. And then up over those hills in that tree line is where he's got his blind. So we'll be separated far enough apart. And again, not too far down that path is where the house is, so that's where we kind of find our new camp spot, but either way it won't be a far walk in the morning, so that'll be good.
Morning walks are what sucks. We're all good.
Getting kind of thirsty already. What time is it?
All right, so.
Yeah, I've got good signal.
Let's go crush a couple pints. Get the guns dialed in.
Huh?
Huh?
What? You tell me when. Coasting. Oh, it's a little wetter than last time. Uh-oh.
You guys want to improve the ventilation in your truck cab camper? Yeah, try one of these. I'll do a video on these probably this week, hopefully. I'm gonna bring this home with me. It usually stays in the truck, but it's simple. Again, I'm just gonna set it up quick now because we actually want to try to hurry up and try to get out and see if we can catch a turkey roosting. But I'll do a separate video on this. I'll try to throw a link in to show you, but it's cheap. Starts off as a little bag, a couple little tent poles, but watch what happens. guys want to check out how to improve the ventilation in your truck cap camper, grab one of these. Like and subscribe. Let me know you're interested. And I'll do a separate video just on this alone. It is a huge game changer for me.
Get me a beer and make me a sandwich.
Sandwich?
You know, it'd be sweet if it was actually fishing season lately. This stuff would burn hot.
Hot's good, just
hot and long.
The sausages I brought.
That was a plug for Amazon, by the way.
You know, I can never remember that name, Plug, because I kept thinking, what is it when people do things when people are
during the Leafs game?
During the Leafs game?
Yeah. I was like, hey, Dave.
Hey, guys, we got the trailer loaded up with wood. We're going to take her down to the camp site, the camp site.
Yeah, it's about a 6 kilometer drive from here.
And there's the house. Uh-oh.
It's a Honda. It starts up every time. Don't worry about it.
I just heard different.
1999 Honda 4-track 350.
Is there any more?
300.
Is there any more cold beer in the fridge while I'm up here, or do you get them all?
There's two more cold ones in the fridge.
You want one while I'm going?
Sure.
Well, we're obviously heading to the fridge. Home. What is this? What is this? Mountains are blue. Goes Maddie on a 6 mile hike. I'll fix it. So yeah, today we are not gonna probably be taking guns up, obviously. So we might go see if we can still catch a roost somewhere to set up for the morning. But if not, tonight's a relaxed night. Tomorrow's an early morning, so the sooner we get drunk, the sooner we go to bed, the earlier we get up. That's hunting.
Pretty good. Oh, those are all Jay's. This is the only one I've had.
Yep. All right, guys. Well, bugs are bad today. So we got the fire going, throwing some smoke around, enjoying a couple beers while the sun's out. Gonna probably get this thing lit up, get a dinner going soon. Get ready for tomorrow morning. Matt, how you feeling about tomorrow morning?
Well, not good, but.
Positive
we
thoughts.
Had a turkey come on the game cams, was it yesterday?
Yesterday it was.
It was a young Jake and a hen. And other than that, not much, but doesn't mean that they're not out there, so we're gonna go out and see what there is. I can barely hold my gun up, I might have to shoot.
Yeah, they don't.
My opposite way tomorrow. I think I can do it though. Because no bird gets left behind. I also learned that from Navy SEALs.
No,
it's a great show, Navy SEALs.
Hashtag Navy SEALs.
Hashtag Navy SEALs. It's actually helped me out with my relationship with my wife. True story.
Oh, yeah?
If you get to season 6, well, I'm only on season 5. So season 5, that's changed everything for me.
Oh yeah? For your sure. whole life. Are you basing your whole life on show?
Yep, but I'm very aware of my surroundings and towers and snipers and whatnot, but that's a whole nother.
Because we're going to get them in that bush. You got them cougars and coyotes. And
actually, there was a cougar sighting not far from there.
Yeah, I know. There's all of them.
I'm thinking, well, I don't know about cougars. I never dealt with one of those before, but hopefully that doesn't happen. We don't come across that.
Doesn't matter. Got a shotgun anyways.
And you got your everyday carry pocket knife. Mine is from Civivi. It's got the button shut. Here, I'll pull it out here. Actually, I got this straight from Civivi.
But can you get it on Amazon? Because you can
You can't get anything cool from Amazon as far as...
All my shit I have in my truck is from Amazon.
No, I'm
everything.
Just, I'm just saying, like, weapon-wise, everything is from the States now. So I
yeah, and they got cool shit in the States.
Yeah, sometimes it bounces back up, but that's my everyday carry now. Yeah. So, I guess if a cougar did attack from the woods...
What are you going to do with a knife? A pocket knife.
Better than nothing.
I know, but he's going to be on top of you, chewing your face, and you're reaching in your pocket for a knife.
Well, I also had the shotgun.
Oh yeah, you got the shotgun. And Casey like bypasses the shotgun.
Yeah, Casey just tackles me from behind, then I can pull out my side carry. And...
Yeah. Just when he's got the hold of the back of his neck.
Happens, but you can't shoot him from the couch. Don't forget about that. You
can't shoot him from the couch. Again, I'm new, people. I have not harvested an animal yet. I have hunted fourth season, I think. This is my second spring. I've hunted two falls, and this is my second spring. So this is my fourth season. And I've yet to harvest an animal.
I've got lots.
It's because you watch Navy SEALs. Maybe I'm going to start watching Navy SEALs. And maybe I'll get a turkey. Guys, it's 11 p.m. Had a few drinks by the fire tonight. Feeling pretty good. I am nice and comfy now in bed, so I think we're gonna call it a night. And alarm set for 4:30 in the morning. Gonna get out there and see what we can do for getting a bird. We'll see you in the morning. Good night, y'all. Get the coffee rolling.
Well, guys, it is bright and early. Sun's not up yet. It's almost 5 now, but I've been up since like 4:30. Let's go get us a bird today. All right, guys, it's bright and early. Camera actually makes it look a lot brighter than what it is. Sun's not even up yet. Just waiting for Matt to come out of the house. I slept like a baby. Today it's not even that cold. I'm the cold this morning, so that's a bonus. But I'm gonna truck my way up to the blind. Hang out there for a couple minutes. Get a coffee in me up there. Stay quiet, listen. If I hear anything, make a couple calls. And today, because it's nice out, it's gonna be a running gun day, so we're gonna be hitting those woods. We'll check in with you in a bit. Here. It's kind of camo mesh. It's see-through from one side though, which is pretty cool. So I threw out a Jake and a hen today. We're gonna try those to see if that'll lure any big beards in. Oh, guys, we're in the blind. It's it's 20 to 5. I got everything set up. We got our decoys out. So far, I'm not hearing any gobbles. That they're not here, so I'm gonna probably gonna have myself a coffee, hang out for a little bit. Sorry, I thought I heard something, but it was geese. But yeah, I'm gonna have a coffee, hang out a little bit, get my ass woke up, and we'll go for a run. It's a big ass woodpecker. The road out there is super busy today. I don't think I've ever heard it that loud. I couldn't even have a nap if I wanted to right now. I have yet to harvest an animal. I got to take a shot in the fall at a turkey with my bow. But I totally wish I had footage for that. It just haunted me forever. I ended up skinning him with the arrow. And got a handful of feathers. But I didn't hurt him at all. He flew away.
Just spooked him, I guess. So that's good, you know. Hopefully he'll come back. If I see another turkey with a bald ass, I know that's the one. So my weapon of choice is the Remington 870 Super Mag Express. 28-inch barrel. I'm running the Carlson Longbeard turkey choke. I do have a Bushnell. I can't remember what number it is, but I got the red dot. My eyesight's not the greatest, so red dot it is for now. Right now I'm shooting the Winchester Longbeards. Winchester XR Longbeards. 3.5-inch. That's what I got loaded in here now. I do have a couple threes, but wasn't sure when I bought it, and it leaves a number five, so after doing some research, hopefully this will be the one. Damn, shooting those 3.5-inch when I was trying to dial it in. Left bruises. Sitting, waiting, walking. Kind of gets frustrating after a while if you don't get one. But just being out here, sitting down, taking in all the noise in the morning is quite nice, actually. Beats sitting at work.
Morning. Seen a fox this morning, that was it. We were here 2 days ago. Matt got pictures on his cams. A few yards away from my blind. Now you don't even hear anything. He's up in his blind right now. He can't even hear nothing. There's no gobbles, there's no clucks. So we're gonna go back, make a sandwich or something. Grab a coffee, hang out for a little bit, and then we're gonna go on a hike up to the woods and see if we can find anything up there. Coffee time. Right, so coffee's on. When these here go orange, water's ready. Meantime, let's get the sandwich going. That's a big one.
that's a sandwich. There is no way I'm eating all that.
Oh man, I love this setup so much.
Yeah, it's gotta be nice with the back open on a nice day like this.
Yeah, I actually had to put the fan on. He's starting to get a little warm. Yeah, okay, we just came back, had something to eat, coffee. I had to take a little nap. But now, I feel great. I think I'm gonna get maybe a bottle of water in me, get packed up, and we're gonna head back up, see what we can find.
Not even moving. So Kingston jumped in the pond and the goose came.
Running and gunning doesn't seem to be the way today. Been out in the bush now for a couple hours. Show you what I'm looking at. Got the decoy just sitting over there. Yeah, that actually started to get frustrating. Not hearing a peep. Might be beer time early today. Well, I'm back in the blind. Been walking the bush all day. We have heard nothing. Nothing.
Matt did say he saw one. He thought he saw what he thinks was a hen up and we're up in the woods. But it was a little too far. It was way out of range and on somebody else's property anyway. So, but here in Ontario, we do have the law of only hunting till 7 p.m. So that leaves me 40 minutes and I was working my way back. So I figured I'd stop in here for the last couple of minutes just to see if I can catch anything. At least even walk by me so I can kind of get an idea where to start in the morning. But yeah, this is, I think, day number six for me. And still, it's just been quiet every time I come out. It gets frustrating. It does, but I guess that's why they call it hunting, not catching. So it is awesome being outdoors, though. Just sitting out here in the field, listening to the forest come alive in the morning. It doesn't get much better than that. It gets me away from the city. It gets me away from the people. Spend time by myself. And Matt, when he's here. So yeah, we got about another 45 minutes to wait. 40 minutes, I guess. And I'm going to head back to camp. And I'm going to be cooking you that dinner that I mentioned. It's a very simple, very basic dinner, but it tastes amazing. So we'll see you back at camp. All right, guys, so as promised, the camp and cook. So one of my favorite meals of all time when I'm camping is I've always known it to be called camp hash, which involves basic hash browns. Got some little pepper. We've got sausages. These are bacon and cheddar sausages. You have to ignore the background. Somebody's talking to their child. We have onions. Now, normally put garlic in, but Matt was able to find some wild leeks today. So we're gonna throw some wild leeks in there. We also put in some mushrooms. We have Mexican style corn. Basic butter. And then to top off, what I like to do, throw a little jalapenos in there. Jalapenos. So, let's get to cooking. All right, so first thing we're gonna do, is we're gonna add our hash browns. I wanna get them as crispy as possible. Way better when they're frozen. These ones are sitting in the cooler, so they're not frozen, but they're cold. Sausage, get them all sliced up. Now while that's going, we're gonna prep our peppers. Beautiful.
Nice.
Ooh, look at those jalapenos.
Jalapenos. Matt's taking over the grill.
Hey.
Now my man needs some help over here.
Leaks are everywhere. It's leaking.
You see what I did there?
Oh, leaking.
Yeah. Because they're leaks. Or they're called rants, actually.
Rants?
Rants or ramps? Rant. I'll have to look it up. It's like a wild leak, so I'll just take over your whole show right here.
No, you can do whatever you want.
Yeah,
So a good time for those is, I'd say a week or two into May. And then once the leaves get back on the trees up there, it's in the maple forest up on the top, so it gets sun. So once the leaves come in, it kind of drowns out the foliage underneath and then they die off. So it's a short period of time to harvest them, or whatever you want to call it. Go pick them. You got to dig them out of the soil. Much like fiddleheads or whatever. Very short time.
Alright, so the hash browns are getting crispy, so we start adding this stuff in. We're gonna get some grease with the sausages and some juices out of the veggies here, so it'll soften them up. So that's why I like to try to get a head start on those.
A bit of a mix.
Season. Okay, a lot of Cajun season. Our corn, mushrooms. I'm lazy, I bought diced ones already. And the kicker, some jalapenos. I'm gonna lose half it. I'm cooking for three, so I had to double up, triple up the actual the amount of ingredients. Okay, so I don't have a lid for my frying pan, so I have these steel camping plates. It all came as a big set, big Coleman set. So I usually keep them in the truck at all the time. So hopefully we'll make do with that. It smells so good. Alright guys, so that's pretty much it. I'll show you. It doesn't look like much. It's mush, but it tastes amazing. Recommend if you have a chance to try it, to try it up. It's good, it's quick, it's easy, it's cheap, and it's a great camp meal.
Okay, we're rolling.
Good, man.
Looks so awesome.
Good.
I like the jalapeno.
That's me. I just love the flavor of the smoked sausage.
Corn.
Sausage and jalapeno mix.
Damn.
Again, if you cook the potatoes from frozen, mm-hmm. they actually become crispier. Really? But because of all the juices and the grease from the sausages and the juices from the veggies, it just mushes them back up.
Well guys, another day's gone by. And skunked again. But it's just fun being out here. It'd be nice to get a turkey. At least once. But I'm gonna be headed out first thing in the morning. I think we're getting up again 4:30. Going to get set up. Get hidden in the bush before the birds start dropping off the roost. And like again, hopefully, I think I'm only gonna spend a couple hours though. I think I'll probably be heading out 9:30 or so. I gotta get home. I will be coming back out again this week. I'm gonna spend a couple days at home and then I'll come back out a couple more days. I'll depend on our weather, I guess. I'll keep that in mind. But as of now, I am exhausted. I'm not even gonna watch a movie. Today was a long day, so I think I'm gonna hit the lights and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Maybe not.